In Sacramento with a look at their expansion.
The reopening today at 3 o'clock. You know that saying, go big or go home? That's what's happening here. If you take a look at what's going on in the street, I have Michael Hargis, the owner, with me right now, because you are taking that whole concept of alfresco dining to a whole new level.
Well, yeah, we're doing a whole massive beer garden on the street. We have this kiosk that we're building over here, which is going to be for counter service. We're going to have bar service there as well. We have about 8,000 feet so people can spread out, keeping people socially distant. It's going to be amazing.
Yes, so this street will be closed to traffic. It's going to allow for a lot more space, like you said. You also are offering in-house dining again. So talk about that experience and how that's going to look a little bit different.
So we are actually going to a counter service model. We're actually going to be greeted by a host, and we're going to sit people at a table, and then they're going to have the opportunity to go and order from a counter. That way we can stay away from menus and paper goods and touching those kind of things. And then, yeah, that's how it's going to look.
So you guys have been closed since the middle of March. It's been a lot of work, a lot of prep getting ready. What we're looking at right now, this is something that is brand new to you. And this is going to be done today by 3 o'clock, fingers crossed, right, to get everything going. So explain what this is going to look like out here.
So we are bringing trees. We are bringing bistro lights. Like I said, we have this kiosk that we're building. It's all going to be clad in white plastic. It's going to look really, really cool. And you know, we're going to have a bunch of two-top tables and benches and things like that, to where if you come as a family, you can sit together. But then if you're coming as two tops, we'll be able to keep you 6 feet apart. So it's going to be really cool.
Such a cool experience. And as if you haven't been busy enough, next door, you're working on another project that you're expecting to open here fairly soon. Tell me about that.
So, yeah, we're turning our butcher bar into an all plant-based concept called Love Child.
Courtney, did you hear that? All plant-based,
what?
Love Child. Keep listening. Okay.
Yeah, so it's nutrient-dense, chef-driven, delicious food. We've got our chef that's coming over from Beast and Bounty. His name's Hamilton Lee, who's gone all plant-based since we opened Beast and Bounty. And we're going to have a lot of fun with it. It's going to be delicious food.
That's exciting. And that's planned for roughly?
Mid to late August.
Mid to late August. Okay, I know this has been a huge undertaking for you, getting all this ready. A lot of stress, a lot of sleepless nights going into making it all happen. How are you feeling today, though? I mean, this has been 3 months now, waiting to be able to welcome the public back in. And you're feeling pretty ready today.
Yeah, I'm extraordinarily excited to get the doors open, to get our family back together, to bring the community back together. I think that there's, during this time, it's going to be incredible to just see all the faces come back together.
Okay, and let's remind people about this menu, because you have awesome food here, so food and drinks, but let's talk about the menu real quick.
Well, remember, we did win Burger Battle 2 years in a row.
Don't forget the important stuff.
Just a reminder.
So yes, some would say best burger in Sacramento, but we are a sausage joint, so we got our artisanal sausages made in-house. Duck fat fries, we've got the hot fried chicken sandwich. It's absolutely delicious. We do have some vegan options, and then of course beer and cocktails and all the other fun stuff.
All right, Michael, congratulations on opening back up with this really cool new concept. This whole street going to be able to allow a lot of people to come in, social distance, and enjoy some good food and drinks. Guys, I'll send it back to you.
Great.
Right on. Thanks, Lori.
Awesome stuff there. All right, well, a local church has an event that is scheduled for all ages.